Hey everyone, and welcome back. You all know that it's not what you say, but how you say it. For example, you know the importance of facial expressions, body language, what someone's doing with their hands, and how their body is turned. You even know the different tones of voice. So, if I speak more slowly and in a deeper manner, I'm probably telling you about something very, very serious. But if I'm high-pitched and speaking really fast, I'm probably really excited to tell you something. But what we're looking at today is where we place the stress in a sentence. And for this example, we have an example from the book Organizational Behavior by Robbins and Judge that was published in 2017. And they give us one simple example of, why don't I take you to dinner? Now, on the surface, this is just a simple question. But when we put the stress on different parts of the sentence, we can dramatically change the meaning. So let's say, why don't I take you to dinner? So we're putting the stress on the word you, right? The question here isn't just simply, are we going to dinner? It's, why don't I take you to dinner instead of Sally, or instead of Fred, or instead of Joe, right? The focus is on the you. So the question here isn't whether or not I'm going to dinner. The question is, am I taking you to dinner? Now, if I say, why don't I take you to dinner tonight? Here, we shift the focus. So, in this case, the person that we're asking, let's just call her Sally. Sally is already going to dinner. We're asking, why don't I be the one to take you? Perhaps Sally was going to go with Joe or Steve, but she should come with us because we are a lot cooler. Why don't I take you to dinner? Here, we're putting the focus on the word don't. So, we're looking for reasons not to take this person to dinner. Right? So perhaps they've been having a bad attitude, they've not been texting us back. Why don't I take you to dinner? I'm not going to do it, right? So even with this, we're shifting the meaning of the sentence just by changing the stress of one word. It's the exact same letters, it's the exact same punctuation, it's just changing the stress. So let's go through a few more examples so you can understand this point. Why don't I take you to dinner? So here, someone has perhaps rejected our proposal to go to dinner. We're looking at reasons why they don't want to go with us. So perhaps their car is broke. Perhaps they can't find a babysitter, right? So we're trying to solve the problems when we put the focus on the why. Why don't I take you to dinner tonight? So here, the focus is on take. So instead of this person going to dinner on their own, we are going to take them. Maybe they don't have a car, maybe they're nervous about going out, but whatever reason, the question here is take. We are accepting the responsibility for getting them to dinner. Two more here. Why don't I take you to dinner tonight? So here the focus isn't on if I'm going to eat or who's driving. The focus here is on dinner. So perhaps we had planned a lunch date, or something else. The question here is, why don't we do dinner instead of breakfast or brunch or lunch, right? And then lastly, why don't I take you to dinner tonight, right? We're putting the focus on the word tonight. Now, this is important because it could show urgency, or it could also be putting something off. So if I just met you and you want to go to lunch or something like that, we're going to say, hey, I'm going to do dinner tonight, right? I'm doing it tonight. So it's showing that urgency. We're not going to wait till tomorrow or the next day. We are doing this tonight. Or in another case, perhaps we had plans for a week from now or 2 weeks and something popped up on your schedule. So we say, hey, we are doing this tonight, right? So the point that I'm trying to make here is you've heard this before, it's a cliche. It's not what you say, but how you say it. And it's not even how you're saying it so much as where you're putting that stress within the sentence. So we have the exact same sentence that can have seven different meanings, seven different answers based on where we put the stress. So if someone's answering the question, why don't I take you to dinner tonight? This would be the seventh example. We might say, well, I can't go to dinner because I have a doctor's appointment, right, at night. Or if someone's saying, why don't I take you to dinner tonight? The response might be because I'm going with Fred, right? So the answer to the question is going to depend on how this person interprets the question, and how they're interpreting that question comes from where we put the stress. I know it's a lot to think about. It's something that I don't even think about on a day-to-day basis, but we have to be understanding that not only do our words have a specific meaning, but where we put our stress, where we put those annotations, those all play a role in how someone actually understands the message that we're trying to convey. I hope you found the video useful, and I will see you next time.